Hey guys, welcome to another gym vlog video. Sorry that I haven't been uploading more. I've just been really busy with my schedule. I still kind of do have a busy schedule because it's now summer for me. I'm out of school. Big plans for the summer. I have a meet, I said, in mid-July. And I have football starting up now. So I've had football from 7 to 10, and right now it's about 11 o'clock. So we're hitting this workout in like really late in the day. I'm really sad because I haven't been able to see my other friends in the gym. My room is a bit messy, so that's one thing I'll be doing later today. But for right now, we're rocking the gym fit with a Rogue camo sweatshirt and some black camo shorts. And underneath, actually, I am repping the Train Harder shirt from the KML Movement. And if you guys haven't heard of that, it's a great business that my friend Kelsey started up. It's basically a movement that supports women into pushing them going to the gym and competing with powerlifting. It's a great place to be in, a great community as well. Hopefully future in the summer, I will be more included into the KML Movement with Kelsey and her whole entire team. I am 14. So hopefully, fingers crossed, I can get a little bit of an internship to get a little bit of some interaction with the training and coaching aspect of the field of that I want to go in. So that'll be fun later this summer. Hopefully we could record a little bit, might go on a podcast, hopefully. Kelsey, if you're watching this, I mean, I wouldn't be too mad if we went on a podcast and just, you know, be a part of that for a little bit. I have seen a few comments saying that you guys want to see more stuff outside the gym, and that is coming out on the way. I'll be doing gym vlogs, and outside the gym vlogs, I will be doing other videos, just the normal day in the life. And sorry if this doesn't come out in like a week or two. I'm just really busy. I have work, and I only have a few days that I have free time because I have, again, football 7 to 10. I have a little bit of time to rest up, and I go straight to the gym. And also, I went on a DC trip, so I haven't had all the time to record. And I couldn't record there because it wouldn't be really respectful to all the people that died into the places that we went to. So yeah, I will hopefully have a video out every single, not maybe not every single, but a video coming out on a Sunday. So it might not be next Sunday, it might be the Sunday after that. Other than that, I've also bought a new pair of training shoes, these Noble shoes. I've heard a lot of things about them, that they're like CrossFit shoes and all that stuff. And I was like, I mean, I'm kind of versatile with like powerlifting and football and all that stuff, because I'm gonna be doing sprints. And these shoes, I forget exactly, I think they're the trainers. These Noble trainers are the best I've ever had so far, because I've had the Rock shoes. They're not as good as what you think they would be. They broke down in like the first year that I was using them, and like the sole started breaking up. And the thing is, the sole of the shoe is like gooey. It's not an actual sole. But these things right here, they're a game changer.
Before I say another word, just know that my intentions were pure. But you can't stand to be in silence. All you can hear is your own voice, fueling delusion in you, and I'm just so sick of backing down.
So, I didn't realize, but today I am going for a PR. For low bar, right now we're going for about like 290 to 300 pounds. It's about like 90%, so it shouldn't be too bad. But, see what we can do.
I want to feel what I felt before. But you just keep moving towards me. What do I do? What do I say? Can you kindly just refrain? What's in for me? Why I betray? And I feel nothing for you.
Alright, so that was a PR, and I'm not sure exactly, I forget what my last squat was. I do know that my last competition, I hit, I think it was like 265. So that was a big jump from there. That was just 300 pounds. I was really impressed because I worked out earlier this morning with football, and I was not feeling it in my warm-ups, but then I hit that. Depth was a little bit questionable. I like to go a little bit deeper, but I'm hyped. I like it. All right, so squats right now, I'm not feeling the best. Yesterday I did an SVD day, so I went heavy on row bar squats and bench and deadlifts. I also had football lifting, but those are no excuses. So my 300 pound squat went well. It could have flew a lot better if I had rested. That's just to go to show like how much resting in workouts is like really good. So I was supposed to do 275, that's what I had the bar on before. I only did it for one rep, so I'm gonna rest up right now. And then I only have one set of 275, so I'm going to rest up a little bit, get a little hydrated, and then just bust my ass as much as possible. Basically go for as many reps as possible, try and get up to four. If I don't get up to four, I'll at least get three. I'm gonna grind it out as much as possible. I have safety spot, like little hooks, so if I do bail, it's not a big deal. But yeah, just gonna rest up and give it all that I have. Guys, we are back home from the gym and it's kind of late at night. Well, not late at night, it is like about 7 o'clock. So With that being, we're gonna be making some dinner. You guys said that you want to see more content outside of the gym, so here we go. We're making some tuna, and I'm not sure if I'm gonna be putting on like French toast, but like on bread or something, like a little tuna melt. I haven't decided that yet, but we're gonna make some like nice tuna fish, and you guys want to try this recipe. It's so good. I'm kind of winging it, but it's gonna taste the best. All right, so first you're gonna want to take your tuna fish. The Starkist is my favorite. You're gonna want to get a big mixing bowl. Here we go. We got a mixing bowl. We got our tuna. You're gonna want to add some stuff to the tuna. So for right now, we have the 11-ounce pack. We're just gonna dump all that in there. And also, if you're wondering why I have my shirt off, this is the Anabolic Kitchen. So anything worth being anabolic is worth having this shirt off to, you know, show some guns. And yeah. Alright, so the biggest key ingredient is mayo, because, well, one, it has some healthy fats from eggs, and also it just makes it taste better with the texture and everything. So you're going to want to put a lot of that in there. Like, when I say a lot, I mean like a lot. Like that amount, a lot. And after that, you're just gonna want to like mix that in, just stir. It's gonna give it a good consistency, and a lot of flavor too. And after that, you don't want it just to be bland, so you want to give it some salt. And it can be like any salt that you want. Pink Himalayan normal salt. I like to use normal salt. Before workouts, pink Himalayan salt kind of does hit. And it should be like not thick, but it should be like more of a runny consistency. So like, yeah, you heard that. We have our mayo in there. We have our salt in there, and to put a little touch to it, I like to put like a little bit of seasoning other than just salt, so like some flavored seasoning. So our options here, my favorite seasonings, we got these seasonings at the Arnold when we went. I wasn't vlogging at the time. I probably should have vlogged that. But I forget exactly what the brand name's called. It doesn't say. But that right there, that company is the best. They have the best flavored anything when it comes to seasonings. So my favorite when it comes to this stuff is the Honey Beast Barbecue. And it tastes so good. So we're gonna throw a little bit in there. And then just mix that around. And normally when I make this stuff, you like wanna douse it in salt, because normally tuna fish, I mean, it soaks it up, but to get good flavor out of it, you gotta put a lot in. And I have this 11-ounce packet, so it's gonna take quite a bit. It's a little bit better. And the best combination with that honey barbecue is the black rub. It's a rub, but for me, honestly, it works better as a seasoning, especially combined with the Honey Beast Barbecue. I don't know what about it. It just has a good flavor together. I will say this is my first time using these seasonings on a tuna, recipe. So I'm kind of curious of how it's gonna turn out. It is turning into like a different color, like a more like barbecue-y color, but like an orangish. But that's not bad. It's just adding flavor. Yeah. That tastes good. All right, so here's the key ingredient. It might sound nasty, but it's Dijon mustard. It gives it that like little kick, but it's like, it's the type of like thing that just wraps it all together. Not too much. So I already put a lot of that on, a lot of the mayo in it, and we don't want it like too runny, because we still want to put it on like a type of bread to make it a tuna melt. but we still wanted to like give it that oomph to it. And actually, fun fact, I packed, when I was meal prepping, I packed a little case of tunic, so it was just easy to throw in there. And I didn't have enough time to finish it at lunch. So my next period was LA, and I was like, ah, fuck it, I'm gonna eat in LA. So I didn't realize that, or like I at least forgot that tuna stinks. So I opened it up, like started eating it under the desk, and everybody just like says, "What the hell is that smell?" And like, teacher saw it and she told me to put it away. But so my nickname in LA or language arts was Smelly Summers because of the tuna fish or tuna tucker. Those are the two nicknames that I got from that experience. But it was really funny. But I mean, at the moment, I thought it was what you had to do, because you normally see those the videos of people saying, if you're gonna do it, you're gonna be dedicated, you gotta do it in the moment. So I did it in the moment. So we got our tuna right now. We gotta grab our little pieces of bread. Like I said earlier in the video, I have football starting with conditioning and all that stuff, so I'm gonna be eating a lot more. The amount of calories that I was eating on the regular before football was about 2,500 calories. But now I'm up that to 3,000. Just mainly because of the amount of cardio that I'm doing, but that's gonna come to bite me in the butt. Just because I have a powerlifting meet in mid-July, and we have something called camps or camp days in football. I know this is not like a bread knife, but we don't have any bread knives right now. It's gonna work. But we have something called camp days, and it's basically when we're doing a shit ton of conditioning. Doing a shit ton of conditioning as well as learning plays. So they're crucial to go to, and if you miss a day, it's really hard to make it back up because they don't have any more camp days. So if you miss a day, you're screwed for the rest of the season. And I don't want to be running for like 4 hours, because it goes from like 7 to 12 in the morning, so it's a long time. But I don't want to be working like that hard like 2 days before a meet, because I think my meet is July 24th, and the last camp day in July is the 22nd, I think, or it's like the 20th. So I'm gonna be like, I'm gonna have my meet like 4 days after I've been like sprinting and like working my ass off in football, which is not gonna be good. But it is what it is. I mean, dealing with not a rest day, because last week I went to DC, like I said, and I didn't train as much, so I fit a SPD day yesterday, and that was supposed to be my rest day, and I still hit a 300-pound squat. I mean, it was a bit of a struggle when it shouldn't have, but still, I mean, if I saw where I was last meet and where I am now, I'd be like, hell, I have no idea how I'd be able to do a 315 squat. And now I'm like just buttoned up with 315. All right, so this is what we're looking at right now. We have the garlic powder on top with pepper and our everything but bagel seasoning on the top. And we are going to put cheese on right now. Alright, so what I basically did is I took the fat-free cheddar and just sprinkled it on there. It's going to come out it's not going to come out as well as if I put normal cheese on, but for me it works. And I mean, it has a lot more protein than other cheese, and if you really think about it, fat-free cheese is really just like a really good protein source, because if you look at it, it has 45 calories per serving, which is 1/4 of a cup, which a normal bag is like 105 or like 120 per like 1/4 cup. It has the exact same amount of protein, and it has 9 grams of protein. And that's like 9 grams of protein for every single 45 calories, which for me is pretty good. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take these and slide them into the oven right there. I forget exactly for how long, I'll just keep an eye on them. And we'll see how it goes from there. Okay, so I got finished with all the tuna melts. I put them in the oven for about 5 minutes for 350, and then boiled them on high for about a minute, minute and a half. And then I sprinkled a little bit of salt on them. So I just used the cutting board as a plate, so I don't really want to make any more dishes. But I'm going to finish up these, and then that's gonna be about a video.